We all know the name Chipotle, but how many of you know they grew from a converted Dolly Madison ice cream shop in Denver to over 1,000 locations in the United States, Canada, and the United Kingdom, generating over $1.3 billion in sales today? Now, their origin story isn't the only thing eventful in their journey. Over the last 4 years, the controversies they've been in have made sales dip by a considerable amount. But they didn't back down, and within no time, they made a comeback to stand tall in the food industry. What do you think could be the history behind this billion-dollar restaurant chain? Let's find out! Steve Ells, the son of a pharmaceutical executive, was born in Indianapolis on September 12, 1965. At a usually young age, he developed an appreciation for fine cuisine, so much so that he spent his free time watching Julia Child's cooking shows instead of cartoons. When I was in the fourth grade, I used to make eggs Benedict before I had to catch the school bus. Although his interest pulled him in a less than average path, he lived quite an ordinary life growing up. He graduated from Boulder High School and went on to the University of Colorado at Boulder, where he earned a bachelor's degree in art history and joined the Delta Chi fraternity. After he graduated, culinary took hold of Steve, and he chose to attend the American Culinary Institute in Hyde Park, New York, and be a part of the class of 1990. He was a fantastic chef in college. His love for food shone through as he threw dinner parties to cook excellent meals, almost everything, but strangely, never Mexican food. During his time in San Francisco's Mission District, where he worked as a sub chef, he was inspired by fat burritos bundled in a giant flour tortilla wrapped in foil. The idea struck him to twist on this traditional Mexican peasant food by stuffing the tortillas with gourmet ingredients, leveraging his culinary knowledge. In Denver, Colorado, close to the University of Denver, he opened a Chipotle-themed taco shop with $85,000 borrowed from his dad. The idea he had in mind was named after a smoke-dried jalapeno pepper, a heavily used ingredient in the cuisine. Things kickstarted well for Steve. He and his father estimated that the shop needed 107 burritos a day to sell, but for his luck, the original restaurant sold more than 1,000 burritos a day after 1 month. Over the next few years, additional outlets in the Denver metro area were opened, financed with an extra $1.5 million of investment from his father and $1.5 million private stock. Initially, Steve had intended to make use of the funds of Chipotle's first restaurant and focused on Chipotle Mexican Grill when the restaurant was able to succeed. The venture capital companies were more involved in flying software at the time, so a Chipotle executive board member had given McDonald's Corporation an unsolicited business plan. The timing was just perfect for Steve. Domestic sales flattened the burger giant, and the managers were looking for a way to boost growth. This was a turning point in Steve's career when McDonald's invested in the firm as a minority in 1998. By 2001, the firm was the biggest investor for Chipotle. The investment of McDonald's enabled the company to quickly grow from 16 restaurants in 1998 to more than 500 by 2005. Steve was smart enough to make sure that he remained the head while the managers, as well as the menu, remained the same. He continuously worked on growth being generated through company-owned outlets. Now, with the backing of much deeper pockets, there was a clear potential for franchising, eventually through McDonald's system of franchisees. In 2002, there were 55 more Chipotles and another 70 in the next year, bringing the total to 300. Chipotle was one of the fastest growing restaurant chains in the nation when it celebrated its 10th anniversary. Amongst others, the chain entertained the markets of Las Vegas, Atlanta, and New York in 2003, when Technomic projected its sales to be $321 million, which was a big deal for Steve. McDonald's retired from Chipotle entirely in October 2006. This was a part of McDonald's broader initiative for dismantling the principal McDonald's chain from all its native business restaurants, including Chipotle, Donato's Pizza, and the Boston Market. Chipotle repurchased the few franchises it had sold after McDonald's disinvestment and became 100% owned by the company. In 2007, Chipotle was released. Steve was an individual who was always concerned about sustainability and his surroundings. He had made only minor changes to the still simple menu in the 11 plus years he had been in business and continually sought new organic ingredient sources. It's not just about fresh anymore. Fresh is the minimum that you have to do in this category now. You have to be concerned about where your food comes from and how the animals were raised. I call it food with integrity. The rapid growth of Chipotle and its consistently stunning financial results made Chipotle a pool of investors. Its dedication to fresh, high-quality inputs at only slightly higher prices contributed to a new wave of fast casual restaurants. Steve developed a very efficient cooking method, which had little to do with the existing fast food method of freezing, heating, and serving. The funny thing is, he never really wanted to invest a lot of time in the burrito company when it started. But everything else has remained almost the same. From trying to be as fresh and local as possible to see your food settled as you order it, and we prefer it that way. If you enjoyed this video, consider hitting the like and subscribe buttons. It does wonders for the YouTube algorithm, so more people can see our videos and so that you can be notified when we launch our next video. We try and put out at least one new one per week, and as you can imagine, the research and editing alone of these type of videos takes us close to 18 hours. So we would really appreciate it if you could also check out our Patreon. For just $1 a month, you can support our work. We produce over 12 videos per month, so that is literally 8 cents per video. Thank you so much, and we'll see you at our next unmasking.